रेडी स्टार्ट. अ कॉन्जॉइंट रीडिंग ऑफ द अफोरसेड प्रोविजन डेफिनेटली इंडिकेट्स दॅट इन केस एनी व्हेकल इज टू बी प्लाइड ऑन अ पब्लिक प्लेस ऑर एनी अदर प्लेस टू मेक द इन्शुरर लायबल टू पे द कंपन्सेशन अंडर द पॉलिसी ऑफ इन्शुरन्स स्टॅट्युटरी रिक्वायरमेंट्स हॅव टू बी नेसेसरिली फुलफिल्ड अँड दीज रिक्वायरमेंट्स आर मोअर स्ट्रिक्ट इन द केस ऑफ अ ट्रान्सपोर्ट व्हेकल. नीडलेस टू से दॅट रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ हॅविंग व्हॅलिड लायसन्स इज अ statutory requirement and absence of validity license is a statutory defense available to the insurance company. It need to be highlighted that the liability of the insurance company is contractual in nature. Insurer is only an indemnifier and his basic liability is on the wrongdoer, that is the driver. Thereafter, the owner is vicariously liable for wrong committed by his employee agent. It is only by virtue of the contract of insurance between the owner of the vehicle and the insurance company as per chapter 9 under section 147 the insurer is liable to indemnify the owner for third party risk. The law as developed is that in case of breach of any policy condition after making payment to the claimant as it is beneficial legislature, the insurer can recover the amount from the owner in case of breach of any policy condition under the policy as per the statutory requirements. A vehicle owner is under statutory obligation to have itself vehicle registered in a case of transport vehicle. Necessity is to have a certificate of fitness under section 56, without which the vehicle shall not be deemed to be validly registered for the purpose of section 139, and there is a statutory obligation to have permit in a case of transport vehicle to use the vehicle in public place, whether or not such vehicle is carrying any passenger or goods for the purpose of playing in a place. In case all or any of these statutory requirement noted above is lacking, the insurer can avoid its liability. Apart from the statutory obligation, in the terms of contract of insurance, it is clearly provided that vehicle will be driven by a duly licensed driver or otherwise the insurer will not be liable to indemnify the owner. Para. Having noticed above statutory requirements, the most pertinent thing to my mind is that statutory requirement may not have any relevance with the actual cause of accident or the negligence or the manner in which the accident had taken place. For example, if the other statutory requirements are satisfied but the vehicle was not registered, still the liability can be avoided by the insurer. Similarly, in a case of transport vehicle having a valid permit or not, may not be relevant with the actual case of accident on the issue of negligence, but still the liability can be avoided by the insurer because it is a statutory requirement and as such it is a breach of policy condition. Similarly, there is a requirement of fitness certificate in a case of transport vehicle, which is also essential for registration. Stop.